channel. I'm Mr. G, and in this video, I would like to take you in a galaxy far, far away. Wait a second, that sounds familiar. Anyway, we're going to embark on an interstellar journey that has left us stranded inside an asteroid full of resources, but where oxygen was not included in a travel package. So, let's see how far we can survive inside this asteroid, and if we can actually leave the asteroid itself. So let's start a new game, be a survival one, and let's pick the starting asteroid. Let's pick one that is challenging but not too difficult, so one where survival chance is probable, possibly. There are some resources, and let's see, this one doesn't look too bad. This one, survival chance is likely. Metal poor, okay, I don't like that. I like the fact it's gold, because there's an interesting challenge about that. But let's see if there's any other one. This one, yeah, still like the chance to survive. That's good. Magma channels, no, irregular oil, it's okay. I'm not sure. Anyway, unless you pick up when one of these ones, yeah, like this one, for example, where some of the chances are moderate, the other ones are fairly easy with some challenges. So I think I'll pick this one. Metal rich, that's good, and surface ocean, alright, it's a salt water sea, okay, that's an interesting one, so let's start the game. So, for all the viewers that don't know about this game, I will explain the mechanics and everything while it's playing. So the first thing, as we saw, we picked the starting zone. It could have been completely randomized, but I picked one specifically. Now let's pick the three starters, so the three duplicates, as they are called, that will start building the colony. So I want some good characteristics, so possibly someone that has got some plus in building and digging possibly. Now they all look fine, especially there is no one. Okay, this one. Bottomless stomach, so yeah, good traits and bad traits. Yeah, husbandry one. Probably, yes, I'm going to reroll this one because I need more. Yeah, this one's got research plus science plus QC, wrenching, and the other one as well. Max has got some wrenching. Okay, I think we got a good start. Can reroll as much as you want, but I would like to keep it a bit random enough to see what happens. I tend to avoid mostly people that are loud snorers or people that snore during the night or have negative attributes. These ones look fine. And here we are. So yeah, we've awoken in our target location, but colonization efforts have already hit a hitch. We're supposed to land on the surface of the planet, but we can be getting trapped many miles underground instead. So let's see if we can get back to the surface. First things first, as they say. Let's have a look around our initial biome here. It's always good to have a look around. I can see already there's loads of copper ore, which is good. We have a nice reservoir of water just above us, which is good and bad because I'm used to have water below the starting zone. It's just a bit unusual for me, So let's start digging. That's the first thing you do. So in this game, of course, you have to establish some basic elements of survival. One is oxygen, of course, hence the title of the game. You have to produce oxygen. In the beginning, you are bestowed with some oxalite. That's the blue thing emitting bubbles just above us, but it will decay sort of rapidly, so it won't produce oxygen for too long. Our duplicates anyway emit carbon dioxide and consume oxygen, so as we will see in this game, there's a continuous consumption of one resource to produce another resource. Basically, each time you produce something, there's a byproduct of that production that you have to deal with. Now, the basics, as I was saying, the basics is secure some oxygen production, some toilets, because our duplicates need to use toilets. Barracks, or anyway, a place to sleep instead of sleeping rough on the rocks. So, and we'll start researching various technologies that will allow us to progress and keep surviving. Now, I'm already building toilets, and the way I'm positioning the various buildings, as they are called in the game, I'm already thinking the way I will build the room, the toilet area, so it will host more than just these two elements. What I will do is for now just prepare one sink and one toilet, and hopefully they will build it very soon, because I think that within one cycle or one day they have to use the toilet, otherwise they will make a mess. They will make a mess. So here we are, we have our first two elements. Now we have to build in the whole room. Now what I want to do is to create a water tank for the water just above us. So I will force them to go up and start carving out the water tank, because we have sand. The problem is that we have sand around the water, so as we see now, the moment you start digging at the sand, it just falls down, it won't stay in place. So if you do that and there's water above it, well, gravity is a thing in this game, so we'll just make things more difficult. So let's avoid digging with the sand. So the idea is to basically go around and start digging from the inside of what will be the inside of the water tank. As we can see, the temperature around us is blue, meaning it's cold, it's very cold. So that would be a challenge for growing crops and food in general, and things that we can harvest that would Using other means. So as long as in the beginning you have a toilet and some beds, you're fine for quite a few cycles or days. That's how days are called in the game. And we finished our first day. Exactly what to do, but you can set priorities way I built the toilets, 3 and 3, and because I think, yeah, that's how I do it. I don't think there's a, wouldn't be a problem to have 4, maybe 2, but I think since we start with 3 of them, instead of having 1 here, 1 there, just a room with 3 and 3, I think it's 3 is the perfect number. I'm not sure. Someone says that. So now, yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to dig from the inside, because if we dig from the outside and start building the floor of the water tank, it's going to collapse everything because we have sand. And so since I want to leave a space of 2 tiles between the top of the toilet and the base of the water tank, the solution is to start digging from the inside. Now, probably I will make a big water tank, so we'll dig out the central rocks that divide those 2 parts you see there. So it will be one big water tank. That's also unusual from other playthroughs that I had. Usually you see some water reservoirs. Instead of having one big one like this one, basically I consider it as a one big water tank or water reservoir. You see 2 quite separate ones. So one could be on the left side of the starting area, one could be on the other side, on the right side. So they are 2 distinct, they are in 2 distinct positions here. Basically it's just one big reservoir. And in fact we have our rooms, so the rooms are also colored. You see we have 2 rooms now, the barracks and the toilets. Now the barracks are quite small. This one is just it's a cave. Basically it's a cave. 3 beds, but it's a room. It's got a floor, it's got a wall, and a room, so it's a room. Hopefully there's no, I don't think there's no, none of the duplicates have a claustrophobic kind of characteristic or something, so. Again, my usual approach is to have rooms of 5 beds, so we make 2 more enclosed room, then I will add another room of 5 and possibly another 5, so usually I stop around 15 duplicates. I don't invite more than 15, or at least that's the initial goal. Time I might have more than 15, but we'll see. So yeah, and we got our water pump nice and ready to be built, so they can finally wash their hands and eat with clean hands. Let's see how long it will take them to actually build it. So now I just have to positioning, yeah, that's better, because it was unreachable for them to build. So now they can actually reach it and build it. And in fact, that's the first thing they do. That's good. So now we've established really the real basics: the barracks, the toilet, and a source of water. So now oxygen and other gases can flow freely. And so we put another one here on the other side. Now, maybe you can already understand why I like much to have the full, but that's our first. Blueprint available that in this moment I will just accept the care package. It's too early, I think, to invite another duplicate. So you have to be careful and conscious in because in this moment I'm not producing food at all. I'm just eating what I find. Just let them eat what they find. So if you invite too many duplicates, it's a problem. They will start, they will consume all the food, and probably that will be the end of the colony. So as I was saying, you might have already kind of understood why I didn't like start to have that water reservoir right above the starting point, because my approach is to have these two shafts that go literally almost bottom. They won't go all the length of the asteroid, but they will go in up and down, so for quite a while, at least two long ladders. So you can see already that the long ladder, it won't be that long because I'm blocked going up. They will go down, and I will definitely have another ladder on the left or on the right. See, probably on the left, that will go. They will extend up and down, but the central ones that I like to have, they won't be like that. They will only have my direction now, which is annoying. Now has to hit more than 1,000. there's a geyser or a volcano or a vent that emits something. Could be water, could be fresh water, cold water, could be natural gas, could be chlorine. So, and it's important to discover them. I would say almost as soon as possible to start having a source of possible water or a source of power. If it's, for example, natural gas. Now they built, oh, okay, we have our first skills, we can assign something they can do, what the beacons can do, we can work better. Now they built the manual generator. I can already choose, yeah, what to research, and of course I will research the jumbo batteries, because we need bigger batteries, and now they're running. Now that's useless, because it's not giving power. Oh no, it's giving power. It is giving power to the computer, but it's not giving power to the batteries, so they will run forever. Or rather, until the researcher has finished the research, and so they won't do anything else. Now I changed the priority, but they won't make any difference because they will finish the current task, so they won't change what they're doing. Now, unless I let them run till the end of the day, they won't move. They will just stop once the end of the day, and it's just almost midday. And that's work to do. That is work to do. Now, the only way I think is to, yeah, to force them to move somewhere else. So moving them to somewhere else, they will reset their task. Now, yeah, they went back to it, but they're building, okay, they're constructing the battery. So even though it's running, it's running for no reason, now the battery, okay, perfect. At least now he's running for a reason, and also his friend, okay, but at least now they're doing the correct thing, they're charging the batteries, when the batteries will reach 100%, they will stop. Oh, right. Now it makes sense. What they were doing before, it didn't make sense at all, and you have this kind of nonsense in this game. See later on. Oh, perfect. Now we have one skill to assign. Now I will give them what they like to do, because I will give them morale, which is good. And it's also what I need them to do. So I need a researcher, I need a digger, and I need a chef. Actually, I would need someone that is doing construction. Building, but I'll just pick up what they like to do for the morale, and we have new duplicates, new blueprints. Let's see. Now I'm tempted to invite the fourth duplicate, but maybe it's a bit too early, because we're not producing food on our own yet. These ones are good, not excellent. I see construction, some decorating. Yeah, well, doctoring is not essential at this moment. Decorating looks good for the morale. Some might be tempted to invite Nicola. But maybe it's a bit too early. So yeah, actually, let's take the package. Now finished the research, the first research. Let's pick minutes. And we're finished. The oxygen diffuser are first. So we can produce oxygen in a proper way finally. Let's see. Oh yes, yes. Everything was turning red, dark blue. So now, I think that the basics of the base have been set. Not all of them, but almost there. So for now, I think we can leave the colony here. So we can end episode 1 of this playthrough. I will of course come back for an episode 2. Hope you've enjoyed this one. And as always, if you liked the video, please like and subscribe, and I will see you all next time.